We've completed the derivation of the differential and computational equations, and now all that's left to do is a couple of projects. These are standard cases in the literature. The first is cavity flow. Our cavity is, of course, a 2x2 square, but it could have been any size rectangle. It's filled with fluid, and the fluid at the top boundary is moving to the right with a velocity of 1 meter per second. We want to see what flow it induces in the cavity. Boundary conditions are shown in the diagram. The parameters for the simulation are the grid is 10 by 10, mu is 0.1, rho is 1, and dt is 0.001. The program from the previous video should work fine. All that's needed is to adjust the boundary conditions as shown in the next slide. And here's what the results should look like. There is one run with the flow arrows superimposed over a pressure map, and one with the flow arrows superimposed over a velocity map. Project 2 is flow over a backward step. It takes a little more programming effort because now we have more than one rectangle to deal with, and there are also more boundary conditions to be enforced. The diagram shows the boundary conditions. The sim parameters are the grid is 30 by 15, the step is 10 by 10, and again mu is 0.1, rho is 1, and dt is 0.001. The program is almost the same as the previous one. However, since there is some additional twiddling to be done because of the step, the outline is given below. The results should look like this. Again, there are two runs, one with a pressure map and one with a velocity map. The assignment is, of course, to reproduce the results in the vid.